Welcome to another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. One thing that all rock stars agree on, they would rather sing than lip sync. It makes me wonder, is the food on your dinner table true? Food adulteration is a growing concern, no pun intended. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's explore food authenticity. Basmati or not basmati rice? That is the question.
Hi, Jen.
Hi, Gareth.
You okay? You look confused.
I am a little confused. I'm not often in the lab, but actually, could you help me for a minute?
Sure.
I was wondering if you could give me some advice, since you do a lot of this food testing. I found this recent report on food authenticity, and a lot of my favorite foods were in there. So, Gareth, is food authenticity a real problem?
Oh, yeah. Food adulteration has been going on for centuries. Pretty much anything that's expensive or difficult to grow as a big opportunity to be adulterated. And so therefore, what you think you're buying is not authentic.
So what you're really saying is that there's more demand than there is supply.
Yeah, I mean, for sure. I mean, Manuka honey, just in the UK alone, sells more Manuka honey than is actually produced globally. So somewhere, the amount of honey produced is not meeting the demands.
Interesting. So how can we test for this?
Well, let me show you a few things, what we've done recently with basmati rice. What we do is we follow this typical workflow, pretty much trying to get from research to routine. The research is the fun part. We collect a non-targeted data set using accurate mass technology, and then all of that data gets pushed into an informatics package, a very sophisticated informatics package, which can look at all of the data at once and compare different groups. When we compare, we see thousands of ions which are the same and some which are different. And it's these ions which are different, which are highlighted here in the long grain rice or the basmati rice, which are unique or upregulated in the rice. We can then take those adulterants or those potential adulterations and push them into a routine situation where a user would look on a tandem quad at a rice for specific molecules and get the answer. Is this rice authentic? Is it adulterated?
Wow, Gareth, it looks like something so complicated we've really made into a routine type of analysis.
Yeah, I mean, it's not easy, but recent advancements in hardware and software and informatics is really helping the cause. There's lots of other analyses which this workflow covers, things like allergens in food.
Well, now I feel a lot better. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Protecting consumer rights and preventing fraudulent or deceptive practices such as food adulteration are important and challenging issues facing the food industry. The need for rapid development of analytical methods to enable reliable food authentication, even if that means a mass spec in the QC lab. So unlike the music business, we have a way to tell if what you are getting is the real deal. For more details, check out the application note we described. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science Rockstar Edition.